Modi government's vaccination policy has abandoned India's young, that is people between 18 to 45 years of age, by government of India saying that it has no responsibility for vaccinating people below 45 years. They have to either do it themselves or the state government has to use their own resources to do so. Incidentally, India's population below 45 years is 74.35% of its total population. That is 101 crore. And now, my friends, people below 18 years are also getting afflicted by corona. We have seen multiple instances amongst our family and friends where children of 5 years, 7 years, 10, 12, 14, 15 years are now afflicted by corona. Number two, Modi government's vaccination policy has deregulated 50% of the production of the vaccine by the two vaccine manufacturers of any pricing control whatsoever. The new policy says, now the vaccine manufacturers will determine the price at which they want to sell to the state government or to private hospitals. Number three, the two vaccine manufacturers have now released a wholly arbitrary price structure. Serum Institute of India has now three pricing slabs, 150 rupees for supply, compulsory supply to government of India, 400 rupees for supply to state governments, and 600 rupees per dose for supply to private hospitals. Bharat Biotech released its own pricing late yesterday night, and they are even more discriminatory. They say 150 rupees for compulsory supply to government of India, 600 rupees per dose for supply to states, and 1200 rupees per dose for supply to private hospitals. I needless to add that everybody requires two doses, so the cost will be doubled. Now, the India's population below 45 years, as I said, is 101 crores. So you will require 202 crore doses. Cost of these will have to be borne by states or by individuals. Based on this, and presuming that 50% of those below 45 years, cost will be borne by the state governments, which may not be true, and 50% will be borne by the individuals themselves. The profit of Serum Institute of India and Bharat Biotech for these 202 crore doses will be a whopping 1,11,100 crores. Modi government's vaccination policy has abandoned India's young, that is people between 18 to 45 years of age, by government of India saying that it has no responsibility for vaccinating people below 45 years. They have to either do it themselves or the state government has to use their own resources to do so. Incidentally, India's population below 45 years is 74.35% of its total population. That is 101 crore. And now, my friends, people below 18 years are also getting afflicted by corona. We have seen multiple instances amongst our family and friends where children of 5 years, 7 years, 10, 12, 14, 15 years are now afflicted by corona. Number two, Modi government's vaccination policy has deregulated 50% of the production of the vaccine by the two vaccine manufacturers of any pricing control whatsoever. The new policy says, now the vaccine manufacturers will determine the price at which they want to sell to the state government or to private hospitals. Number three, the two vaccine manufacturers have now released a wholly arbitrary price structure. Serum Institute of India has now three pricing slabs, 150 rupees for supply, compulsory supply to government of India, 400 rupees for supply to state governments, and 600 rupees per dose for supply to private hospitals. Bharat Biotech released its own pricing late yesterday night, and they are even more discriminatory. They say 150 rupees for compulsory supply to Government of India, 600 rupees per dose for supply to states, and 1200 rupees per dose for supply to private hospitals. I needless to add that everybody requires two doses, so the cost will be doubled. Now, the India's population below 45 years, as I said, is 101 crores. So you will require 202 crore doses. Cost of these will have to be borne by states or by individuals. Based on this, and presuming that 50% of those below 45 years cost will be borne by the state governments, which may not be true, and 50% will be borne by the individuals themselves, the profit of Serum Institute of India and Bharat Biotech for these 202 crore doses will be a whopping 1,11,100 crores.